small enterprises. I'm Alexandria Majala, and now that you know Africa means business, join us every week to meet the movers and shakers of the African continent. Welcome back to Friday Briefing. Thank you very much for staying with us. Like I mentioned, this is a different kind of Friday Briefing. Tonight, we're covering for you the nullified Jubilee primaries. And right now, I want to cross over live and speak to our Jeff Kirui, joining us live from Kericho. Thank you very much, Jeff Kirui. Just talk to us about some of the main issues that affected the exercise back there in Kericho.
Well, a very good evening, Betty. Indeed, there are some of the issues which actually have been an issue in Kericho County regarding the nomination exercise, which was scheduled to take off as from 6 in the morning. But the exercise didn't take off because of the few ballot papers which actually were delivered here. And aspirants, a joint meeting by all the aspirants in Kericho County, say that they want the exercise to be postponed. And indeed, after that meeting, there was a communication from Jubilee headquarters postponing the exercise till further details are given by the Jubilee, of course, officials. And here right now, I'm joined by Benjamin Langat, who is the Member of Parliament in Amwe, and as well as the gubernatorial aspirant in Kericho, just to tell us, to give us the reaction after the postponement of the exercise. Mheshimiwa, thank you for joining KTN News. Indeed, maybe you can just tell us what exactly some of your issues in this nomination exercise, and of course, what you expect the party to do regarding a fresh nomination exercise.
Well, I think we had really expected that the party would live up to its promise that the election process will be free, fair, and transparent. But sadly, in the early morning, we woke up very early in the morning to realize that less than 50% of the required ballot papers had been brought. And so this being a Jubilee area, we had really expected that the turnout of the voters would be in the region of 80-90%. And when you tell us you have delivered, less than 50%, we actually decided as aspirants of goodwill that we were not going to accept a situation where you tell people to line up, then after some time you tell them, sorry, the ballot papers are not enough. So we decided that as aspirants, we want the process to be repeated with full 100% of the ballot papers on time, so that everybody is given time to an opportunity to vote. We had actually decided earlier that we are not going to accept the process to continue. But certainly one of the somebody called regional coordinator kept insisting that it has to continue, it must continue. Then we said, now if we are aspirants, we are not satisfied, and this thing must be consultative. Why would one person continue saying it has to continue? So, and there were fears of, earlier on there were fears of malpractice, or fears of, some people say that there are people planning to rig the election. And when you deliver less ballot papers, 50% ballot papers, sometimes some polling centers, they are given 200 out of, 1,400 voters. How do you do that? So we held a crisis meeting at 1 p.m. With all the aspirants of goodwill, and we decided that this process should be halted until we actually agreed that if it is possible, it should be done on Monday with new ballot papers, different colors of the ballot papers, because the ones which were being used had already been delivered in some areas. So, but I want to believe that if the party had actually said they want to, they have actually agreed to a position that they will repeat the process at another time, but we also want to insist that it should be between Monday, should be actually on Monday, and latest should be Tuesday. because now timelines for IBC also are very close. It's very unfortunate that as a party which we promised thousands of supporters, and we have so many supporters, you tell people that the party expected 50% turnout. How do you, as a party which is serious, and I want to tell Honorable Tuju that you should not live in theoretical world. Politics is about practice, practical world. You cannot tell people we are expected 50% turnout. What about if the turnout is 100%? What did you do? So I think I want to really say it was very unfortunate for the party secretariat to let the supporters. In fact, there was a bit of tension in town earlier on. And the party is almost losing credibility in terms of, you know, the promise you made and then the delivery, which was contrary to what you had actually promised. But I hope and believe that's not too late, that we expect now the process again to restart. We expect the ballot papers to arrive, 100% ballot papers in every polling center. We expect the registers to be correct. This is a Jubilee region, and we don't want to lose our members to other small parties which are beginning to, you know, to grow. And so I think I welcome the decision by the party to accept our position as aspirants to repeat the exercise. But I hope it will be done again in a more careful manner.
Well, you've talked about small parties reaping from this major letdown within Jubilee Party. Do you think that Jubilee is losing grip? Because earlier on we managed to talk to some of the residents and actually they were showing signs of chama chama shinani. I don't know what you think about that.
You know, if you have very close friends, supporters, very good supporters, and then you let them down, I think they also believe, they start beginning now, if our own party cannot take care of us, you know, those questions begin to really, and it's very unfortunate because Jubilee enjoys a massive support, and this is a Jubilee region. But if the party itself, which is run by professionals, Honorable Tuju, Honorable, wherever the other officials, if you cannot even determine how many polling centers, and how many registered voters per polling center, surely what kind of a person are you? And you keep insisting the elections cannot be called off. How can you say elections cannot be called off and you have not provided, you have not prepared for the elections? It's very unfortunate that I heard Honorable Tuju trying to insist that